The Apollo 13. In April 13, 1970s, three astronauts, Jim, Jack, and Fred, are heading to the moon aboard Apollo 13. Everything seems normal until a violent explosion shakes the spacecraft. Lights flicker, alarms blare, and instruments fail. Then, four words that send chills through the NASA mission control.
Houston, we have a problem.
The crew is 200,000 miles from Earth, and their oxygen tank has just exploded. But what no one knew in that moment is that this disaster had been waiting to happen for years. The tank had been damaged 5 years earlier, when it was accidentally dropped during testing. The engineer had noted that the electrical issues before launch, but NASA, eager to stay on schedule, decided to launch it anyway. Now the oxygen is leaking into space, power is failing, and the mission is over. But now the real question is, can they even make it home to their families? Or will they be doomed to drift endlessly in the empty void of space, never to see their families again? With the command module failing, the crew squeezed into the lunar module, a vehicle never meant to keep them alive for long, and it's freezing. They are dehydrated, and their own breath is turning toxic because of CO2 level is rising fast. With oxygen running so low and no room for error, they have no choice but to work with whatever they can find. Using nothing but duct tapes, plastic bag, and a saw, NASA engineer designed a makeshift filter. The crews built it, and it works. Now the final challenge has arrived, getting back to Earth alive. First of all, they had to manually power up the command module, and they got to follow NASA's exact instruction. Using only 20 amps of battery power, barely enough to charge a phone. And they only have one chance, one mistake, they will never be able to get back to Earth. Next, they'll need to use the moon gravity as a slingshot. They had to hit the atmosphere at the perfect angle. Too shallow, and they'll be bounced off into space forever. And the re-entry began at 24,000 miles per hour, slamming them into the Earth's atmosphere with G-force reaching 7 Gs. Normally, a plasma buildup causes a 3-minute radio blackout. Apollo 13's lasts 6 minutes. The mission control are in total silence. Everyone at their home is glued to their TV. They wait and they wait. When they are almost out of hope, then suddenly a radio signal came in. They were alive, the parachute were deployed, and the Apollo 13 splashed down safely in the Pacific Ocean. NASA first framed the explosion as an unforeseeable accident, suggesting it was a fluke rather than a preventable issue. However, an investigation revealed that the tank had no defect before the launch. But in the face of failure, the astronaut refused to give up, and the mission control never stopped fighting for them. Together, they turned Apollo 13 into the NASA greatest rescue, the Challenger Disaster. On January 28, 1986, seven astronauts board the Space Shuttle Challenger, preparing for launch. Among them is Krista McAlifer, a school teacher set to become the first civilian in space. Across the country, millions of students watch live, excited to see history in the making.
3, 2, 1.
But before this, I got something that I need to let you know about. That morning, it was 18 degrees Fahrenheit, the coldest launch in NASA history. Engineers at the Morton Teoco had warned NASA not to launch. They knew that the O-ring had a chance to fail due to the cold weather. On the other hand, if the mission succeeded, it would have sparked a new generation of curiosity, inspiring future scientists and proving that anyone, even a teacher, could reach for stars. The countdown reaches zero, Challenger roars to life, thundering into the sky. Everything seems normal at this point. But just 73 seconds later, a fireball engulfed the shuttle. The Challenger is gone. Debris rained down into the Atlantic. There are no survivors. For the student watching live, the excitement turned into horror. NASA ignored the warnings. They were under pressure to stay on schedule, and against all advice, they gave the green light. As the Challenger launched, the O-ring didn't seal properly. At 59 seconds, a smoke appeared, but no one noticed anything. Then at 73 seconds, the weakened booster gave out. The accident fuel tank ripped apart. A massive explosion followed, destroying the Challenger instantly. But here's a terrifying truth. The crew may have survived the explosion. Evidence suggests that they were alive, trapped in the crew cabin, as they plummeted for over 2 minutes before crashing into the ocean. NASA tried to downplay how much pressure they put on the Morton Teoco to approve the launch. The internal memo later revealed that the official ignored safety concerns to avoid further launch delays. The Challenger disaster became a symbol of reckless decision making, and a hard lesson learned: no deadline is worth more than human life. Apollo 1. Everybody knows about Neil Armstrong. Seriously, he is famous everywhere. He's the first one to walk on the moon, but no one knows about is that his name spelled backward is not Misty Alien. Okay, seriously though, NASA has faced several failures before the Neil Armstrong successful mission. Let's go way back to the first mission, one of the more infamous Apollo program. Inside the Apollo 1 command module, Gus Grimson, Ed White, and Roger Chaffee are strapped into their seat performing a routine pre-flight test. No liftoff, no fuel, no danger, or at least that's what they thought. The spacecraft wasn't perfect just yet. The wires, 100% oxygen in the ship, and the unfinished design. But the test moved forward anyway, due to trying to stay on the deadline. At 6:31 PM, a single spark, the oxygen-rich air erupts into an inferno. The flame explodes through the cabin, feeding on Velcro, nylon netting, highly flammable material meant to keep things in place, now turning the spacecraft into a dead trap. And the heat is unbearable, soaring past 1000 degrees Fahrenheit. The best way to get to safety is to get out of the ship. They aren't in space and the ship hasn't even launched yet. They just need to open up the hatch and get to safety. The crew then rush towards the hatch, pulling with everything they have. They shove, they pull, they scream. But the problem is, the hatch won't budge at all because it was designed to be opened inward and the pressure from the fire sealed it completely shut. They are just inches away from safety, but now it has become miles. Despite knowing that, the astronaut continued to budge the hatch open. One of the crew scrambled to cut off their oxygen hoses, hoping to suffocate the fire. This might be their only chance for survival. But it spread too fast, they didn't even stand a chance at all. Then in just a moment, toxic smoke fills the cabin. The crew outside the ship rushed toward the capsule, their hearts pounding as they reach the sealed hatch. Every second counts. They know that the three men inside are alive, screaming and fighting. But the thick metal exterior holds in the fire completely, turning the cabin into an inferno. The Apollo hatch is a three-piece design, meant to withstand external pressure. In the chaos, that strand has become a death sentence. Others rush in, pushing, pounding, straining against the unyielding metal. The astronaut desperately screams for help, but the team outside the capsule can only watch in horror because there's nothing that they can do. At 17 seconds, the radio falls silent. When the hatch was finally pried open, the rescuer found that the fire had burned everything inside, but it wasn't the flame that killed the astronaut. They suffocated from the toxic smoke before they even had a chance to escape. NASA had been warned, engineers had voiced concern about the faulty wiring and electrical issues, but under pressure to meet the deadline, NASA pushed forward anyway. One of the reasons being that they are under immense pressure to beat the Soviet Union to the moon. The Apollo 1 never flew, but its failure forced NASA to completely redesign the Apollo spacecraft, the Columbia Disaster. For 16 days, the crew of Columbia lived the dream of every astronaut. They had conducted over 80 scientific experiments, studying everything from cancer research to the effects of space on the human body. They pushed the boundary of knowledge, hoping to bring their discovery back to Earth, to NASA, to science, to the future. And now on February 1st, 2003, their mission was complete. All that were left was to go home to their families. Inside the shuttle, the seven astronauts smile, joke, and prepare for re-entry. They look forward to seeing their families, to sharing their success. But what they didn't know was that home was already out of reach since the start of the mission. At 8:44 AM, Columbia enters Earth's atmosphere at 24,000 miles per hour. Commander Rick and Pilot Willie monitor the control. The descent is smooth and everything seems pretty normal. Then a warning alarm. Temperature sensor in the left wing failed. Something is wrong, but to the crew, thought it's just another system glitch. Nothing that they haven't seen before. They have no idea that the disaster is currently unfolding. At 8:59 AM, the shuttle starts veering left. Rick and McCook are trying their best to hold it steady. Then, a loud bang. Let's go back to the 16 day earlier during the launch. During launch, a chunk of foam isolation broke off and punched a hole in the left wing. Engineers noticed immediately and raised concern. But the NASA leadership dismissed it. When the crew asked if there was a problem, they were told, "We see nothing that you should be worried about." The Columbia violently rose. The G-force climbed to 7 Gs, crushing their bodies. The shuttle is ripping apart. The mission control has lost all contact. The last transmission is filled with static. The shuttle disintegrated, scattered debris across Texas, and no one survived. They trust NASA to keep them safe. Instead, they were sent to their deaths. Though the crew of Columbia never made it home, their mission did not die with them. The experiment they conducted in space, the data they gathered, and the knowledge they sought to bring back survived the disaster. Their discovery continues to impact science today, saving lives, advancing medicine, and pushing humanity forward. That's the end of today's video. If you like the video, like, share, and subscribe. Bye!